Well, surprise, surprise. There's a ghost in New York City around Halloween time. So who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
Yeah, I'm sick of that phrase too. But 30 years after the original Ghostbusters stopped Goza the Gozerian and 100-foot Marshmallow Man from the apocalypse, there was a new generation of Ghostbusters who took up the proton packs and raced over an Ecto-3. Ecto-1 was on display in some car museum. They were a bunch of college girls from Columbia. And yes, I said girls, women. Yay for inclusivity. The infestation was in a haunted house of all places. You know, one of those old broken down buildings in Tribeca that decorates their house like a carnival attraction? Of course, most of Tribeca could be considered haunted on a daily basis, but this was different. When the Ghostbusters got out of Ecto-3, there was already a crowd of fans waiting to see them.
Look, there they are!
Oh my God, Ghostbusters, we love you!
They already had on their jumpsuits with black boots and gloves, which, I gotta say, looked much better on them than those schlubby outfits the boys used to wear. While they were getting equipped with their proton packs, Amanda Barrett was first to address the crowd.
All right, relax. Would you people? You're gonna scare the ghost away, which means we don't get paid.
And yes, Amanda Barrett was the daughter of Dana Barrett, who was famously turned into a dog by the demon Zool, also the younger half-sister of Oscar Barrett, an infant target of Vigo the Carpathian, now working for Mayor Mulligan. And of course, she was also the daughter of Peter Venkman, one of the original three Ghostbusters. She lived in the shadow of her father her whole life and would have loved nothing better than to forget this Ghostbusters business completely, if not for her classmate, Kris Lanis, begging for her involvement.
Hi everyone, I'm Kris.
Considered one of the brightest minds at Columbia University and obsessed with paranormal activities from a young age instead of, you know, doing normal childhood activities, she had formed this new Ghostbusters team along with Columbia genius Neema Doppler.
Kris, I'm definitely picking up trace paranormal energy readings from the PKE meter.
This is great. We're gonna catch a ghost in a haunted house. This is like a childhood dream coming true.
Hey, Kris, relax, would you? You're embarrassing me.
Amanda, don't be so negative. We're trying to build a brand here.
Ugh.
That was the newest member of the team, Zoe Sumner, one of those popular blonde types who was probably least likely to pick up a science book. But she decided to be the self-appointed PR person. You could thank her for the stylized uniforms and their public persona, and she was usually the one who dealt with the business end of things. Trust me, you need someone like that when you've got a team of brainiacs. Once they were in the building, some gothic vampire wannabe came up to them. Believe it or not, he was the house manager.
Yes, Ghostbusters, thank God you're here.
Of course. How can we be of assistance?
Well, you can get rid of the ghost that's been scaring my customers.
You sure they're not just scared over how cheesy this house is?
Amanda!
I mean, strictly business speaking, probably be really lucrative to have a real ghost for your attraction, don't you think?
It would be if that thing wasn't spraying slime all over my customers. We're not insured for that.
Ew, slime!
Zoe, don't be negative.
Aside from the ectoplasm discharge, is there anything else you can say about the subject in question? Is it human form, animal form, or strictly an ectoplasmic manifestation?
Allow me, Neema. Okay, Bela Lugosi. I'm just gonna show you a couple pictures on my phone here for reference. This is Casper. He's a friendly ghost. This is the Flying Dutchman. He's a not-so-friendly ghost. And this is Patrick Swayze from the movie Ghost.
Look, I don't know. Whatever it is, can you just get rid of it? And try not to destroy anything in your path. It's very expensive designing this house.
Not to worry, sir. The Ghostbusters are on the case.
Yeah, you three go check. I didn't sign up to have my hair slimed.
Come on, Zoe!
Besides, me and the Count here have to discuss payment.
Oh, how much is this possibly going to cost?
I have the paperwork right here for you to sign. All the fees are listed. Get going, you three!
Geez, she's here a week and suddenly she thinks she's in charge.
Yeah, try being her roommate.
I heard that, Amanda!
You're charging me for hair products.
Yeah. You have any idea how much it costs to buy shampoo that rinses out slime?
So, while Zoe was arguing with the manager about her precious hair, Amanda, Kris, and Neema were making their way through the not-so-haunted house. There were ghosts, goblins, zombies. Oh my. None of them were real. Some of the spiders were real, but they weren't all that big or noticeable. Still, our heroes charged up their proton packs.
Ah, I still love the sound of that.
Trust me, it gets pretty tiring hearing it over and over and over again.
It's different. You grew up with it. I grew up wanting to be near it.
I know, Kris. You wanted to be a Ghostbuster since you were like 5.
4.
Whatever. Can't we nerd out over something else? Here, take a look at this program I snagged. Back in the 1920s, this mansion once housed a gangster by the name of Lightning Luca. I guess that was his portrait back there. Who escaped arrest in 1924 and was never found. Sounds like my kind of guy.
Be on your guard, ladies. The PKE meter is spiking. If my readings are correct, this could be a classic 3 or 4 repeater.
Amanda, check behind me.
It was quiet. Too quiet. Until... a monster popped up!
Damn, you blew its head clear off.
I believe that was paper mache.
Sorry, Mr. Monster.
By the way, that's coming out of your pay, Kris.
I got excited. Look at the head, though. This mannequin sure looks ugly. It's like a Tyrannosaurus Rex with insect eyes.
It's meant to look like a Class 7 possessor called Watt. I remember reading about it in Dr. Spangler's book.
What's his name?
Exactly. You should know all these specters, Amanda.
You know, contrary to popular belief, Neema, I didn't spend all my afternoons locked away memorizing every goblin in my uncle's book.
You say that like it's a bad thing. Kris, something's coming around the corner.
Take it easy this time, Annie Oakley.
A ghost did come around the corner. They were prepared to face the most terrifying, dangerous, bad-tempered ghost this side of the Hudson River. But it didn't turn out to be that.
Oh, God, no.
It's a Slimer. A real-life Slimer.
Class 5, full roaming vapor. I could have sworn this was reading a Class 3.
Hi, Slimer. Wow. He waved back at me. Oh, let me see if I can make contact with him. Shake hands, Slimer. Nice to meet... Ugh, got slime all over my glove. Well, that's why we wear them. To think your friend Zoe actually wanted us to wear fingerless gloves.
Kris, would you stop butting up over this thing? From what little time I spent with my father, I know that these things can be menacing.
Well, I'm just glad it wasn't something more dangerous. Anyway, let's get him back to the lab. He'd make for a good test subject.
Ugh, he went right through me! Shoot it!
He went through the wall. It's like he got spooked.
Amanda, are you okay?
Ugh.
Wow, he slimed you pretty good.
This is the worst slime yet. If I ever see my father again, I'll tell him he's right.
Oh, it's another one of those fake paper mache mannequins.
What?
Precisely.
Kris, I'm getting high psychokinetic readings on that thing.
Kris, look out!
The mannequin ghost lunged at Kris, emitting some electric light which threw her against the wall.
Kris, Neema, shoot it, would you?
It's on the run. I'm going after it.
Come on, Kris. Get up, baby.
I'm okay. Did I ever tell you how happy I am you joined our team?
I know you think I'm hot.
I didn't say that.
Well, you should because it's true.
I...
save it for the bedroom. Let's go bust this bitch.
Back in the lobby, the manager was still filling out paperwork while Zoe was checking her phone.
God, I hate these gloves. I'm gonna insist on fingerless next time.
And here came the frazzled Slimer through the wall to the lobby. Right through Zoe's hair and hovering on top of the chandelier.
That's the ghost. Aren't you going to get it?
Oh, he went through my hair. Ew. It's all slimy and disgusting. Amanda!
Oh my God. There's two of them. It's possessed one of my mannequins.
Zoe, get down.
You put a hole in the ceiling.
Neema, where is it?
Up there. Its PKE should be lowered, but we gotta pull the specter out of that mannequin.
Looks like Slimer is not a fan of it either.
Well, maybe we should wait for it to kill him?
It's a ghost, Amanda. It's already dead.
All right, fine. This is for zapping my girl.
Nice shot. Keep it going. It's getting ripped out of the mannequin.
Amanda ripped the ghost right out of the fake Watt ghost, which fell to the floor.
Oh!
The ghost revealed itself to be a Class 3 humanoid spirit, like a 20s gangster.
Incredible! It's the ghost of lightning, Luca!
Neema, give Luca another stream from the other side.
Remember, don't cross the streams!
Yeah, I know that, Neema. I spent enough summer studying with Uncle Egon to know don't cross the streams. Hey, Zoe, a little help here?
Did you not see I got slimed, Amanda?
So did I. I'm still doing my job.
It's all right. I should be able to trap it. Okay, everyone. Whatever you do, don't look directly into the trap once it's activated.
And if you do, the Ghostbusters will not be held liable for your burnt retinas.
Sorry, Luca. You won't be escaping this time.
Yeah, you're gonna be spending some time in the containment unit, see?
Yeah. You bad guy.
Would you just trap it already?
All right. Cut your stream in 3, 2, 1!
Is it in?
Yup, we got him!
Yeah! Whoa, look out! Slimer at 9 o'clock!
Yeah! Get off of me!
Hey, he likes you!
Yeah, well, he slimed me earlier, so you're joining Luca, Slimer.
Be careful, Amanda.
Here's your science project. Bella, it was a pleasure doing business with you.
What about my mannequins?
If you read section 39 of the paperwork you signed, you'll have your answer. We'll be sending you a final bill soon.
And I'm charging you quadruple for my hair. I'm gonna have to soak it all night once we get back.
Actually, Zoe, I'm going to need to sample your hair for some lab tests.
Oh, why did I join you losers?
Thank you, everyone. Please be safe.
Remember, you have a dose of freaky ghosts. Who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters!
And that was another night on the job for the Ghostbusters. Aside from Zoe's hair, it went about as well as can be expected. Well, except for one thing on the drive back.
What happened?
Looks like the engine died.
Oh, I told you we should have gotten AAA.
Excuse me. I have a hair full of slime that desperately needs a trip to the shower. Can we get moving?
Let me check the engine.
As soon as they all got out of the car, the streetlights all went dead. There was not a person around, so it suddenly became very spooky.
Oh, great. Someone didn't pay their Con Ed bill.
Why are you bothering my little ones?
Who said that?
I think we should get our packs.
Yeah, good idea.
I repeat, why are you bothering my little ones?
Listen, dude, we've kind of had a long night. Blondie here needs to shower, so if you don't mind, we're just
gonna... You are the seed of Peter Venkman.
How the hell do you know that?
Stay out of my way, seed of Venkman. For this Halloween, Eternal Night shall finally come to pass.
Eternal Night? Halloween? Wait, does that mean you're...
Yes, I am Samhain. Stay out of my way, Ghostbusters!
Ah! Everyone, all right?
No, my hair's still full of slime!
I gotta be honest, I'm a little freaked out.
It's all right, Amanda. We're here for you.
Hey, easy with the dirty gloves, okay?
Car's running again. Doesn't look like the PKE meter is picking up anything. Our enemy's far gone.
Then let's move. That's enough for one night.
It was the end of their night, but the fight had barely begun. This Halloween, they would be in for a real fight with an old foe. The new Ghostbusters, written and produced by Jim Savy. Based on Ghostbusters, written by Dan Aykroyd and Harold Ramis. Also episodes of The Real Ghostbusters, written by J. Michael Stracynski. Starring Anne Hurd as Janine Melnitz.
Shannon Gallagher as Amanda.
Jaquelyn Greenspan as Kris.
Kacey Mayeda as Neema.
Fallon Echo as Zoe. And Glimmer!
Charlie Smith-McMahon as the haunted house manager.
And Jim Savy as Samhain and the house ghost. Happy Halloween, everyone. May it last forever.